Okay, now basically we have done register on the login page, so we are going to be accessing input from that. So you don't need this, I don't need this. So this is what we're needing here. So to process input, now you can see this place here is a get request, so we can't process an input there. So basically we have to, you know, change this to something like match. So this is going to match the request get or post. Let's change this to match NTCH. So match will accept an array. So this is going to be get or post. So basically we are also going to do the same thing for the register. Alright, so save it. So now if you reload it, now you can see we still have the same thing here. So we're working with the register controller because you have to first start by registering, you cannot just plug in like that. So the first thing to do is let's first check if the request is a post request. So this is if this was the request get, you can see get method equals to post. So I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna do echo yes. So let's go back to reload. We should hit register now. You can see we are having an error. So why is this error coming? Because in our register of PHP, we did not give it an action that is not needed. I would not give it a method. So we need to pass in the method to it equals to post. Let's go there, refresh. If I should click on register now, now you can see I have yes on the screen. So that is telling me that okay, this is working. Okay, so this is working right now. So now I can go back there now. So I sent inputs from database, use something called request.getVault. So this is going to be, so if you accept input, our first input is just going to be username equals to this dot request dot get bar. So the bar, we store our variable name as what username. So this is not the variable, I mean this name that is here. So it is necessary for you to know that. Then also our email equals to this then request dot get bar. Also this is email, then lastly password equals this the request the get bar password. So we've gotten already. So how are we gonna check if this is working? So let's just try and do something there. So this is data equals to email should be email, username should be username. So we are creating an array so that we're able to check our results, print it out. We don't should use any thing. Sorry. Password should be equals to password. So that is that. So let's just come in. Don't forget to make one. Now we have I don't know what I call it, the function or whatever. Something in code igniter, which is dd, which is die and dot, just like in dark database. So I can just do die and dot this, it's gonna be dd dot and close this. So now if I should go back there and run this, we have nothing. So if I should click on this and put in password and register, and it's register, And you can see we have the data with an with three arrays, which is email, username, and password. Alright, so that is getting close to us. Now, so basically we are not going to be doing this. So let's just delete this first. So to get us started first, we need to first verify our data first. So this is the last part to be looking at this video. So verification, validation. Before I get started, let's create an empty label. An empty label right here. So this is data equals to this. An empty array. Then right here we can now create a variable called rules. So this rules is what is gonna answer our rules to our field. So our first field here is our username. So the username we're gonna assign a rule to it. So I can have it rules should be what required. The label. So once I want the rules to be called, should be username. So let's save this. So that is that. So I can do if not this. So I'm saying if this does not validate the rules, what should we do? Like we assign a variable like an item to our array, an empty array, which is gonna be equals to this validator, then else nothing. So this is a simple code. Don't think it's that it's actually a simple code. ELSE else. Okay, so we have that too. Basically this is not going to work because you've not assigned it. So let's try that. Let's pass it to our register page. So this is going to be PHP if is set. So if the validation item is passed, then we can do validation, then list the errors. Then go ahead and add the if. So this is what we call PHP templating, which allows us to template our HTML files easily without any error. So let's go back there and click enter. Let's try and register. Okay, so this is not working. Yeah, basically because we forgot to pass the data. Yes, so to pass the data we have to just pass our data here. So I should go ahead and replace this. Now you can see the username field is required, so this is working. So let's tie this a little bit by checking the alert. Yes, so this alert here. So I'm gonna be working with the red alert. This is the danger. This is this one. So it's gonna be this. Register to those cruises to make it more good. Let's add the HD right here. Sorry, Ctrl C, let's copy that and paste it here and say error. Alright, so this should be better. So basically I can refresh this. Alright, so this seems better, but why is the color like this? Okay, this is blue gray, so instead of it to be red. So let's refresh this. Alright, so this is good, but I think we still need something like this. A container. I don't like the way it's close to that. Let's try that again. Okay, still is empty. That means I'm not actually good at content, so if I cannot get it, we just have to move on. So let's try DIV bolt. Container. So basically, I don't know what's happening. I think my screen recorder cut off. So basically, we've done that already. What I did was just update was just I added a container here and I closed it so it will be able to look better. Then in the application, we went ahead and added this email and password. So we just copy and paste, then we use, we make a required and make the valid email. So just check for the valid email, then the password, make it required and check for the minimum length of 6 characters. So basically that is just all the simple things we did. So now if we should hit enter now, we should put a wrong email. And this, so we should hit register now. You can see we have this, somehow the password is valid. Okay, yes, there is an add. So we got so let's click register. I can see the email address is not compared by the email address. So that is awesome. Next tutorial will be learning how to, you know, create the user and send them in the database. Also password hashing. See you next time. Thanks.